Allah disguised himself as that cowherd boy and took the place of that cowherd boy. So Sukadeva Goswami tells us that this demon coming in the form and disguising himself as a cowherd boy was known. Lord Krishna was aware of this. But he did not immediately confront him. He enjoys, he's performing his pastimes, and he's taking advantage of this for some further pleasure. He has to, of course, he's going to arrange for the killing of the demon, but he wants to do it in a pleasant way. If Lord Krishna was just to confront the demon, look, I know you're not a coward, boy, I know you're a demon, punt, killer, you know, it wouldn't be much, so much, not so enjoyable. So Lord Krishna remembers, you know, he's with the coward boys. So the coward boys are there with Krishna, they want to enjoy, they have games, they play with each other, and they want to have their fun in the forest. So Lord Krishna arranges that they will play this one game. They'll make up two teams. The two teams will be equal in strength. And when the two teams are equal in strength, then it makes a very exciting competition between the two teams. If one team is very strong and the other team is weak, then it's not very enjoyable. The great warriors, the great kshatriyas, they enjoy fighting people who are their equals. Therefore, when kshatriyas fight, they will fight on equal terms. If one of them is on horseback, the other one should be on horseback. If one of them has a weapon, the other one should have a weapon. They like to fight on equal terms. Then it's more enjoyable, it's more pleasurable. Especially if you win, when your opponent is as good as you and you're able to win, then you will feel very jubilant. So Lord Krishna divided the cowherd boys so that they were equally matched.
And
the demon was in one of the teams. So Lord Krishna has arranged all of this just for the pleasure of the cowherd boys and at the same time so that this demon can be exposed. When the demon is given an opportunity to reveal his nature, then Lord Krishna or Lord Balaram can kill him. They don't want to just only just kill him. They want to see his evil intentions, and then they have good reason to kill him. But Prahlambad is coming, first of all, he's coming as a coward boy. So Lord Krishna accepts him. Okay, let him be a coward boy. He wants to come as a coward boy, and he'll let him be a coward boy. And just like when Putana came as a beautiful woman, and she comes, she wants to feed her breast milk to Krishna. So Krishna accepts. Krishna knew who Putana was. But he says, sure, she wants to give some service. Let her do some service. So here also Prahlambad, oh, he wants to play with us, he wants to join in our game. Okay, let him play with us. Krishna accepts. So this Prahlambad must have had some pious activities that he was able to meet Krishna. We said the coward boys have performed pious activities over many lifetimes to be able to play with
Krishna.
And Prahlambad must have done something, must have had some piety there, otherwise how would you be able to be with Krishna? Although he has a bad intention. Anyway, Krishna understands these things. He knows the nature of everyone. So Krishna arranged this competition with the coward boys and let the Prahlambad demon take part. It was all Krishna's plan to, so that this Prahlambad demon would be exposed. Krishna has many plans, just like we see how he arranged for the battle of Kurukshetra. The Pandavas didn't arrange it, what they didn't want it, but Krishna wanted it. It was the plan of Krishna to bring all these demonic, all these different rulers, different kshatriyas together and let them all fight and kill each other. Krishna arranged all of this so that for many different reasons, many different purposes, by arranging the battle of Kurukshetra, then the earth could be relieved of the burden of so many demonic kshatriyas. And also, Krishna could establish the Pandavas as the rulers. By arranging also the battle of Kurukshetra, Krishna was able to speak Bhagavad Gita. So many different purposes were all served by this plan. And similarly, Krishna arranged for the annihilation of all the Yadu dynasty. But after the battle of Kurukshetra, Krishna was living in Dwarka, and there were so many of his family members, there were so many of his relatives there. And in this way, they could all go back to their places. So Krishna arranges all of these different things to
Then our life becomes suspicious and we cooperate with
And when we accept Maya, then we come under the laws of material nature. So this demon Pralamba, it's the nature of the demons that they're controlled by the material energy, that strong material desires, and they have no interest to surrender. In the Bhagavad Gita, we see there are two natures. There is the divine and the demonic. Somebody was arguing with me, they said, there should be something in between. But Krishna said, no, there's only two, there's the ego and the devotee of the
demon.
If somebody is not a devotee, then they're showing the demonic nature. So it's the nature of the demon that whoever is their enemy, they want to help them kill. The demon is always thinking how to exploit the material world. He thinks the whole world is for his enjoyment. So naturally, when they see Lord Krishna and Balaram, when they see Krishna and Balaram and enjoying in the forest of Vrindavan, then they feel envious. They're thinking, why should they be so happy? We should, we've got to do something about these people. We're not going to let these people. So this is demonic nature. But the devotee, he simply wants to be at least happy, simply to serve Krishna and in service. The devotee feels satisfaction, he feels peace of mind, he feels fulfillment by simply offering service to
Krishna.
It's nature of the soul to give service.
Right?
The word dhamma, the nature of something. Prabhupada explains, just like the dharma of sugar is sweet. If the sugar is not sweet, it's not sugar. And the same way the dharma of the chili is to be hot. If the chili is not hot, it's not a real chili. And the same way the dharma of the soul, the dharma of every living entity is to do service, to give service. We see how everyone is engaged with some kind of service. Mother serving the child. Somebody serving the dog. Somebody else is serving the nation.
Country.
Everyone's engaged in some kind of service. But our constitutional position, our ultimate service, is to give service to the Supreme. In verse Swarupahaya, Nitya Krishna Das. Our eternal relationship with Krishna is as a servant. So, as a servant, we want to think, just like these cowherd boys, they're also serving Krishna, but they serve him in the rasa of friendship.
Krishna,
Krishna, they also think how to please them, and they give pleasure to Krishna by being his friend. So Sakya Ras is this relationship with Krishna as a friend. This is experienced by the cowherd boys in the most intimate way. Arjuna was also a friend of Krishna. You see in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says to Arjuna, because you're my devotee as well as my friend, therefore I'm speaking this Bhagavad Gita to
you.
But then in Bhagavad Gita, we see when Krishna showed the universal form to Arjuna, then Arjuna began to apologize to
Krishna.
He says to Krishna, oh, please forgive me, I was treating you like an equal, I did not know your position. He says, oh, hey Krishna, hey Madhava, hey Sakiti.
Hey Krishna, hey Madhava.
Hey Sakiti. Yeah, he said, oh, I dressed you in these ways, it is not proper of me. I called you Krishna, but actually, I should call you Lord Krishna, I should give you respect when I address
you.
And I called you Saketi, I called you my friend. I was honored, I was thinking I was honoring you, but actually I'm the one fortunate to be your friend. And I was addressing you as Vasudev, and you're the son of Vasudev, but Vasudev is not even a Kshatriya. That my father is a great Kshatriya, but your father, he was just some politician, he couldn't fight with anybody. My father was a Maharati, he could fight with 10,000 soldiers at that
time.
But Vasudev couldn't fight even one person. He wasn't. So I was ridiculing you. So Arjuna begged Krishna, please forgive me for all my offenses. I did not deal nicely. Now I realize your actual position. I can see you're the Supreme Lord. But before, I would lay with you on the same bed and we would eat together just like friends. So please forgive me for being so familiar. And so this way Arjuna, when he saw Krishna, when he understood Krishna to be the Supreme Lord, then he regretted that he dealt with Krishna so familiar. But the cowherd boys, they don't have that kind of feeling. They're just full of friendship with Krishna. They think of Krishna as an equal. They don't think of Krishna as God. Okay, any questions? Comment?
So, Maharaj, so we
in our mood to recognize Krishna. When we study, our decision, we are talking about the mood. How we want Krishna with a friend, so our mood is only certain of the service. Or the little people.
Well, first you have to be a servant before you can be a friend.
Like Krishna, Maharaj, some servant Krishna,
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught us that our constitutional position is to be the servant of
Krishna.
To serve Krishna as a friend is not. You have to be, first of all, an advanced devotee to enter into that relationship. There are 9 kinds of devotional service. And of these 9 kinds, 2 are very difficult to achieve. They are surrendering everything and becoming the friend of
Krishna.
So in order to come to that level, one first of all has to come to the level of raganuga bhakti, or spontaneous devotion. That one always remembers Krishna, is constantly engaged in the sense. Then you can be able to think about becoming a friend. First you have to nourish the creeper of devotion by a lot of healing and chant.
When you said that 2 things are very difficult, one is when one surrenders everything, and then the other is when they can pick up a friend. But then, could they, are the pure devotees who are there in the Gaurakam, have they surrendered everything, or just partially? I mean, this makes it quite unclear because they are at the stage of pure devotees.
Well, there are some devotees who have surrendered everything. Not all, there are many different devotees in the Bhagavatam. Some were successful and some had difficulties. The example of a person who surrendered everything is Bali Maharaj. So he surrendered everything. But we don't say that all the devotees surrendered. But generally, if they're devotees, we would speak of them as being pure devotees. But there's different levels of pure devotees. Some are on the level of sadhana bhakta and sadhana bhaktas, and some are bhava bhaktas and some are prema bhaktas.
How do
we
know which way to go?
Well, I was trying to be a good son. Right? Trying to be a good basic practice.
Yeah. Just now, Muhammad said, if you are not devotee, then you are good.
You're not in the middle, but sometimes you show the good qualities and sometimes you show the bad qualities. There's no in the middle, but you go from one side to the other side.
Okay.
Yeah.